5 सेकेंड, 2 सेकेंड, रेडी। सर, इट इज माई प्राउड प्रिविलेज टू इनिशिएट दिस इम्पॉर्टेंट डिबेट ऑन द 11th प्लान इन दिस अगस्त हाउस। ऑल्दो आई हैव बीन इन चार्ज ऑफ द मिनिस्ट्री ऑफ प्लानिंग ओनली फॉर अ फ्यू डेज, आई हैव हैड द अपॉर्चुनिटी अलॉन्ग विद माई कलीग्स इन द कैबिनेट ऑफ कंसिडरिंग द प्लान इन इट्स वेरियस एस्पेक्ट्स एंड आई शैल ट्राई टू प्रजेंट बिफोर यू द साइलेंट फीचर्स ऑफ द प्लान इन द परस्पेक्टिव ऑफ गवर्नमेंट्स जनरल ओवरऑल इकोनॉमिक ऑब्जेक्टिव्स। Let me say at outset that the 11th plan covering the years 2007-8 to 2012-13 has been formulated in the light of the development experience of the past 3 decades and the perspective we need to keep for the next 10 to 15 years. The country performance in the past has yielded very valuable lessons and we must adopt our strategy of development in the light of this experience. The initial conditions from which the plan had to commence were far from favorable. 1999-2000 was a drought year during which agricultural production slumped. There was a sharp rise in prices which continued during 2002 and many weaknesses appeared in the basic infrastructure of coal, transport and power which in turn had adverse consequences for industrial growth. Internationally, we faced a sharp rise in prices of petroleum and others imports, while recessionary conditions in the industrialized world held out a threat for our exports. In a situation such as this, it was not easy for the government and the planning commission to chart the course of the country for the next 5, 10 or 15 years, which would be bold or definitive. At the same time, the problem facing the country are so acute that solutions broke no delay. Removal of poverty and unemployment and attainment of self-reliance have been the basic goals of plan development and they remain so far the 11th plan as well. In order to move forward towards these objectives, it is essential, although not sufficient, to achieve a high rate of growth of national income. The plan thus aims at a growth rate of 5% per annum. This is not an ambitious target, especially since 1999-2000 was year of low output, but it still requires assiduous efforts to utilize excess capacity in the system and to build new productive capacities in industry as well as agriculture, in power and transport, so as to sustain the momentum of development in years to come beyond the present plan period. I would like to ask the government why the government has not put the provisions of the Plantation Labor Act into operation. Only certain portions of this Plantation Labor Act are now put into operation. What is the objection on the part of the government to put this entire Plantation Labor Act, all its provisions into operation? If this had been done, certainly some benefits would have been derived by the workers, which the government is withholding at present. Particularly, these tea garden owners take advantage of this. They not only exploit the laborers to the maximum extent, but also put so many other difficulties in the life of the workers, wage cut, etc. When I say they cut the wages of workers, they effect the cut in wages not by direct cut in wages, but they increase the workload, taking advantage of the position in which the workers are now placed. For example, a certain amount as basic pay is given to the workers, but a far higher amount of work is got from them than what they used to do before. Now they have become bound to do more work. The workers pluck more tea today than they used to do before. Up till very recently, one worker was asked to pluck buns from 250 plants. Now he is asked to pluck from 400 plants. That is how they increase the workload. In certain tea gardens, 60-70% workload has been increased. This is generally going on. Government do not take any measures to check that increase in workload. Instead of utilizing this fund, the profits can be controlled. The government should ask the plantation owners to give more amenities such as residential facilities, free education to their children, facilities to plant in fallow lands, etc. Fallow lands are available in certain gardens. These workers should be given the facility to cultivate tapioca and other food materials so that they may meet their daily necessities. The government should ask these plantation owners to increase the wages of the workers and also to increase the wages of those workers who are skilled workers. There is the factory labor inside plantations, and there are field workers, and there are so many other categories of labor. The government is not doing anything substantial for the workers. Sir, I find that something like 1.5 lakh of rupees have been granted to the Kerala government for welfare work among the plantation labor. So far as our experience goes, we never have the opportunity to come across such activities organized on behalf of the government. I do not know whether there is any such activity anywhere. On the contrary, there are certain measures taken under the Preventive Detention Act to fight the workers and to pelt stones at the meetings of the workers, and also to employ police to lathi charge the workers. That is the sort of welfare activities they have been doing. But what we demand is that the government should see that the plantation owners are asked to pay higher wages to the workers and to improve their conditions of living. Now there are one-room tenements, but the workers want three-room tenements, and they have not so far been provided with such facilities. I understand that the government have got some idea of having modern tenements in the states, but so far nothing has been done. We suggest that a part of these profits should be utilized for giving educational facilities to the children of the state laborers. Also, the wages of the workers should be increased, and all sorts of facilities should be provided to the state laborers. That is what I have to say. Mr. Deputy Chairman, I welcome this bill, and I am very glad that the Honorable Minister has given the assurance that this increased cess will be utilized mainly for the improvement of the living conditions of the workers in these plantations. बट आई बेग टू सबमिट सर दैट द प्राइस ऑफ टी इज राइजिंग इन द इंग्लिश मार्केट्स एंड आई सजेस्ट दैट एज गुड बिजनेसमैन वी शुड रियलाइज एंड आवर गवर्नमेंट शुड रियलाइज दैट इफ द प्राइस गोज अप बियॉन्ड अ सर्टेन लिमिट।